the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. My pleasure always being with you in our program, Lead Program. In this episode, we are going to talk about something a lot of people ask about it. How to start new business. How to start a new project. How to start a new service in the church. How to start something. Or how to maintain something. The answer to this question is 3S plus 3E. 3S plus 3E. 3S related to the organization. 3E related to people. So again, how to start a new business, new project, new service, or maintain something that's running and you see that there is like some sort of distraction in it. How to develop that? The answer is 3S related to the organization plus 3E related to people that will help in the new project. 3S. Structure, system, super bonus. Put the 3S in the organization. The structure, the system, the super bonus. Structure. Put a clear structure, which means a clear job description for everyone. Structure is job description. Who is doing what? This is related to the structure. Who is doing what in the organization? For example, as a priest, starting a Sunday school, putting a coordinator. What's the job description of the coordinator? What's the job description of the servant? Make it clear. This is called the structure, which is who is doing what. The second S is the system, which basically the hierarchy. Like the servant will be reporting to the coordinator, who will be reporting to the priest. That's called hierarchy. So the system should be well known in the organization. So the structure, who is doing what, and the system, who is reporting to who. That's the system. The third S is the super bonus. You have to have a super bonus in your organization. Put always super bonus. Like if you did so, there will be this kind of reward system. Yeah, but you know what, Abuna, we are in the church, so what will be the super bonus? It will be entering the kingdom of heaven. Yeah, for sure. That's not the issue. That's not what we are talking about right now. Kingdom of heaven is God's reward system. But what's the super system or the super bonus here on earth? You need to think about something as a super bonus to the servants. For example, do you think before about sending the best coordinators in your church to like the lead program to take a course like that on the expenses of the church because you are caring about them? And that's the super bonus. You know what? I'm not going to charge you for anything, but like go there and we are going to be responsible for teaching you. I'm not talking about leadership, just this is an example. But the super bonus is something like that. You know what? We are going, all of us, to go to this trip. And as a super bonus for those who are serving with us, you are not going to pay any fee. But we are going to host you for this trip. For going to the monastery, we are going to give 50% to those who really proceeded well concerning this project. We are going to start a new project in the church, for example, like the summer camp. Those who were responsible and they did a great job, you know what? Because of this success, the next trip that will be to the monastery or to visit these churches or so and so and so and so according to the church, you will have 50% off because of your success. For example. And again, that's not the only super bonus. Here, the super bonus is different from the reward system. If you remember, I talked about the reward system, it should be with nice words, but just praising them in front of people. But again, for any organization, this should be something called super bonus. What's the super bonus? The bonus that those who are working hard will take it as a reward system to them, something physically. So, for starting a new project or a new business, You should have a super bonus even for the co-workers that are working with you in a business. I'm talking about non-profit organization. No, now I'm talking about profit organization. If it is, please put a super bonus to the co-workers. So number one is the structure, the system. Number two and the third S is the super bonus. And then we're going to talk about the 3E. The 3E is related to people, to the co-workers. E, the first one, is envisioning. E number two, enabling. E number three, energizing. Envision. Envision is to deliver your vision to your co-workers. As a priest, you have coordinators. Please deliver your vision to your co-workers, to your coordinators. What's your vision? Your vision, for example, for the next period is developing the biblical concepts. I want all the kids to be understanding the Bible. I want to focus on the Bible. Maybe another vision. I want to focus a lot on the hymns. I want to focus on the behavior, on the attitude, on the positivity, on the organization. Send your vision. Please envision. Envision is delivering your vision to them. The second one is enabling. Enabling, give them the power, the coordinators, give them the power and the authority to proceed in your vision, to do it. So give them that. Not everything to be through you. This is micromanagement. But give them the freedom and give them the power to start do what should be done. The third one is energizing. Empower them. Energize them. Motivate them. This is needed. They need motivation. But again, you can use the super bonus, which I told you, in the organization, and you can use the psychological reward system, which is nice words and the praising of them in front of others. So, in order to start a new business in the church or in your personal life, or to maintain a project or to start a new service, you have to have the equation of the 3S and the 3E. The 3S, structure, which is job description of each, system, hierarchy, who is reporting to who, and the third S, super bonus system. And then the 3E, which you should do with your coordinators or leaders or your followers. Envisioning, which is selling your vision to them or delivering the message of your vision to them. And number two is enabling, allow them to take the control so that they will proceed in the success of your vision. And then energizing, which is empowering them and motivating them to do your vision. We have a verse in the Bible. It's in Proverbs. It's in Proverbs chapter 6, verse 6. I want you to listen to this. Go to the ant, you sluggard. Sluggard is the lazy person. Consider her ways and be wise. Work hard, please, not to be like the ant. Work hard, don't be lazy. Why I am telling you this verse? Because working hard will help you to make the equation of the 3S and the 3E successful. This equation is really good. It will help you. Don't be lazy. But it's depending on you through God. Please never to forget about this. And the application of that, I want you to read Exodus chapter 18. It's the part where Jethro, the father-in-law of Moses, he told him how to judge people in a hierarchy. He put him the system, the hierarchy, and the structure, job description of each, and the super bonus that all the business will be running well, you will be successful, people will be following God, and they will be rewarded from God through this. Moreover, and that's why, this is the 3S and the 3E. Which is when Moses took this envisioning, he started to select people and to tell them what's going on about the advice of Jethro. And moreover, he not just envisioned, he enabled them. He allowed them to do the job. And moreover, he was always energizing them. As we talked about Nehemiah before, energizing others, empowering others. For you, I want you to look at this for yourself, for your personal application. Please, put in your mind the 3S and the 3E. Which one is missing in your organization or in your way of dealing? In your way of dealing will be one of the E's. Either you are not envisioning, or you are not enabling others, or you are not energizing them. It is okay just to know. In your system or in your organization, what's missing? The system, the hierarchy, or the structure? The job description is not clear for everyone. Or the super bonus, there is no bonus, there is no reward system. You know, actually, for the servants in the church, one of the super bonus or the reward system, make a trip for them and you take all the expenses and tell them that this trip is on your own. This is a super bonus. But to what extent you are doing this as a priest? For sure, I'm giving you just an example as a priest, as a coordinator, as a servant, as kids, for what you can do. You can do the same in the business. And the lifestyle. So what you are doing in your home, with your family, you are putting a structure. What is the job description of each and the structure and the system and all what we are talking about? And how do you use the 3E? So again, in order to benefit from this episode, please write the 3S and the 3E in front of you. Tell yourself exactly this question. What's missing? Just understanding what's missing, you are going to complete it right away. Always my pleasure being with you. Thank you so much. Follow us at www.theleadprogram.org. Always my pleasure being with you. Be the one, lead the way. Whoever desires to become great among you shall be your servant. Again, hope to see you all in the Lead Program or Lead Beyond on our website. Go and register with us. It's always our pleasure being with you. Thank you so much. Looking forward to seeing you in our next episode.
To lead you must serve, inspired by your example. To teach you must learn, before your visions are reality. Walk what you preach, so you can lead the way. To lead you must listen, be open to new ideas, admit your mistakes, to earn the trust of all who follow. Walk what you preach, so you can